I see mostly two areas that are interesting, the blockchain activities and AI, and then especially the combination of both have the most potential, I'd say. I'd say everything related to, you have mostly two areas in banking, right? One is front end, one is the back office, and the requirements are different. So in the front end, I see a lot of natural language processing activities, and they will have the highest return, I would say, also on investment. In the back office, it's much more diverse, right? You have all these legacy systems that have to be dealt with, and a lot of optimization, automation of processes, I would say. There's a lot of room in banks. You know, a lot of the banking systems are 10, 20 years old, and to replace them with modern AI is a major task. You have cloud migration, for example. I'm working in both fields, in more narrow AI applications for banking, but also on AGI and alternative AI. In these last two disciplines, you will see probably some quantum leaps very, very soon that will solve problems that haven't been able to be solved in the past. The narrow AI field, although, is dominating still the market and will so for a certain period because it's a more proven technology. So, but I think the short term will be more narrow AI, deep learning, these kind of things, but midterm, long term, it will be more advanced AI technologies. I think I quickly mentioned already the AGI and the AI. I think that's the big fields in the future. So the current AI models, they're all models that are derived from the brain, how the brain works. But there are more interesting models these days, especially for distributed systems, swarm intelligence and so on, where you look more at colonies like ants, how they work, how they operate, how intelligence emerges in these things. And even if you look at bacteria, which have been around on Earth, you know, for billions of years, way before we humans were there, they can be extremely smart, they can self-organize, they work together. So these are new paradigms for AI that I will be using very, very soon. Yeah, I think one of the most interesting companies that I know of is again an Asian company, and I'm involved in that as well. Want to make a little bit of advertisement. the company itself is providing a platform for AIs in general. So instead of you working with one AI, you work with this platform, and then use the service of this AI, but this AI in itself then uses other AIs in the background you don't even are aware of. I think that's a very cool approach. It's a general AI approach and a very powerful one because it has a self-organizing effect and it has an underlying economy, you know, because these AI modules pay each other for their services. So this is one very cool area. A lot of other areas I think worth mentioning are especially everything around messaging system and integrated AI in these messaging systems. But again, the Asian model there is a bit different from the European model because in Asia you have much less privacy concerns and regulations and rules, right? So you can do things in AI with AI in Asia you would not be able to do in Europe.